Let's get it. Give yourself a break. Let me say that again. Give yourself a break. It's okay. Have you ever noticed that when something good happens to you, you celebrate for a little bit, but you soon forget about it and you move on to the next task, right? But when something negative happens to you, you hold on to it. It's because of negativity bias. Now, what the negativity bias states is that when something equally positive and equally negative happens to someone, the negative outweighs the positive. For example, hey girl, I just want to let you know, you are beautiful. Oh my God, what? Thank you. Oh my God, you're so nice. Thank you. That compliment feels good. We love the compliments. It makes us feel great about ourselves, but we soon brush it off. Now, if somebody does the opposite, shoot, she ain't all that. She ain't that cute. Look at her feet. Her feet look like she's been moonwalking on sandpaper. Uh-uh, girl, did he just say my feet look like I've been moonwalking on sandpaper? Oh, uh-uh. That positive compliment might stay with you just for a little bit. But if somebody tell you that your feet look like you've been moonwalking on sandpaper, basically you got some rough feet, that's negative things stick with us. I mentioned this in my last video that, you know, there was a study done that shows that you hear no you can 150,000 times by the time you're 17, and you hear yes you can 5,000 times. So we're already conditioned to hear more negative than the positive. If I go off for 8 auditions, if I get 2 or 3 of those auditions, that is a high success rate. Naturally, in this business especially, you hear more no's than you hear yeses. So it's very important that you train yourself to get out of the habit of the negativity bias. Cognitive reappraisal. Now, what does that mean? In short term, cognitive reappraisal simply means looking at something in a different perspective, right? So finding the positive in that negative experience. This activity I do when I travel is called the I'm the shit activity. And I talk about how my second foster mother used to tell me all the time, you ain't shit, you ain't shit, you ain't shit. So imagine being a kid hearing that, being conditioned to believe you're not shit, that you're stupid, that you're dumb. You know, I got called stupid so much as a kid that at one point I thought that was actually my name. When I was going through therapy at a younger age, it was very important to learn the cognitive reappraisal. So now when I look back on that experience, I can look at it differently from a different lens and a different perspective using cognitive reappraisal. And so now instead of thinking, you ain't shit, you ain't shit, now I think, I'm the shit. And this is something you have to train yourself to get out of that habit. When something good happens, celebrate. Take it in. Remember it. Hold on to it. Don't just brush it off. And then when something negative happens, understand it, but don't let that sit with you. That negativity bias automatically makes you predisposed to focus on that negative. And that's very discouraging. That's when guilt comes in. That's when people stop working on their goals. That's when a lot of negative things happen. Henceforth, the negativity bias. So like I said today, give yourself a break. Forgive yourself. Tell yourself it's okay. I messed up. I can start over again. I can continue where I left off. Whatever you got to do, we have to start training ourselves to get out of that. I'm living in that 21st century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it. Scream from the haters. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that.